Continue with the chapter 5. I think we all know that it was about the dams. In the previous lecture, we talked a lot about the dams and how they will be sorry about that. In the past lecture, in the previous lecture, we talked about how to do, how was that, what is the dams, when, what are the means to that, and what we are, what's the types of dams that we have, gravity dams and embankment dams. All the purposes that the dams are used for, we all talked about all the materials, and we say that the more important things for the dams is its height and the height and the type of the dams. Today we are talking about then if we have a dam, and I want, as an engineer, I want to check its safety, because it's very important to know how safe is that dam. So what we are going to do, how to analyze this dam to be safe or not. Okay, what are the main factors that should we have to see is that dam to be acting for or not? Now, just let me check. Okay. Now, the purpose of the having a dam, we say that we have to store water. So basically, there will be a lot. There will be a lot that's coming from the water that's being stored. That's called the main load or the primary load. Also, we have secondary loads, and we have exceptional loads. What are the main loads that we have in this dams? We have, here's the cross section of the dam itself. Okay, this one. Now, suppose that this dam was to be, this is the height of water, the maximum. This is the maximum height of water inside the tank. So this is called H or Z. So we know that the pressure of water at this point is equal to zero. The pressure at this point is equal to gamma H. So the force, the horizontal force, it will be the main primary forces that comes, and it will act on this dam, right? Now, how much is the magnitude? By the way, we are taking one slice. It means for per 1 meter, the width of this dam, I will take only 1 meter for this dam. And look at this one. If I took this one, I will just consider this one. So for 1 meter. Now, how much is the pressure will be? It's gamma H. And so P1, I can say it's equal to 1/2. I will take the area. H, what is the, from here to there, and times the gamma H. Now, it will give you gamma. We know that it's kilonewton per meter square. Times this is meter, right? Now, gamma kilonewton per meter cube, not maybe. So it will be meter square. So it will be kilonewton per meter times 1 meter of the width of the dam. It will give you the force that acting on one meter of this dam. So that's why we have, we call this one as a horizontal, main horizontal force that acting on this one. So P1 is the one that the horizontal, it's called horizontal. We have two types of loads, horizontal and vertical loads. So now this is considered as a horizontal one. Plus, Now let's leave the concrete dam itself away. Now we have, this is one. Now, sometimes there will be, after a long period of times, maybe we will have settlement. The soil, the clay will be settled here, and they will cause a pressure on this, on the dam itself. So this is the sediment pressure. And by the way, the sediment pressure, why it's here zero? It's because it's zero, it's not, there's no sediment here. There's a maximum sediment here. So I can say it's also, it look like water or soil itself. So there will be a pressure due to that sediment, which is called P5. And how much is the value? I should have this depth. Let me say this is Z. So this is will be gamma Z. Z is the depth of the sediment in this tank, in this reservoir, or the expected zone. So 1/2 times gamma Z times 1 also will give another load, horizontal load on this dam. Now, till now, how many loads that I have? Hello?
Hello.
It's 2. Now we have this one and this one, right? Now, in the winters, exceptionally, we have sometimes ice. You know, we have by 116 meters depth of water, so the density here, the in the winter here, it will be hot water, and here is very cold. And then there will be sometimes there will be freezing. And the freezing will make the top cover of the water make to be an ice. This ice, it's considered will give you a pressure. So being an ice will pose the water on that, and it will make a kind of, let me say, a solid material that will act on this one. There will be an action. There will act as a point here, and it will act on this one. Now, it will be due to the freezing, it will be expansion, and this expansion will push, make a push on this side. That's what we call this is as ice. This ice, there is a definition for the ice when it will be considered as an ice. Any freezing is considered as to be an ice, and it will be have a pressure. No, we will have a limit. So if this is, let me, the top layer of the water, and this is the dam itself, and we have a freezing. So the freezing, it comes, it means that, yeah, it will be, here's this layer will become freezing. Now, till how much? Till the thickness of this freeze layer will become 40 centimeters. Then after that, I can say it will cause a pressure. It will make a pressure on this, it will make a pressure on this body of the dam. And here's the body of the dam. So pressure on this will cause, we will cause a pressure on this one. And less than 40, this is if I have more than 40 centimeters or 0.4, 0.4 meter. If the thickness was less than 0.4 meter, then it will cause what? It will make, it can be neglected. The effect of this ice will be neglected. How much, based on the codes that we have for such kind of the ice we have, so for the ice, yes. I think it's 140. It's 140 here. Yeah. I mentioned somewhere here it's 140 something. Yeah, here is based on the code that we have USBR. a code. If I'm sorry, it's not. If the thickness was more than point, look at this one. If the thickness was more than 60 centimeters, should be considered. The load will be expected. So the load will be expected, and the load will be 145 kilonewton per meter square. It means there will be pressure on this side by 145. And this is if the thickness was more than 60 centimeters. So it will be considered as a zero if the thickness was less than 40 centimeters. And if we have more than 60 centimeters, it will be considered as 145. So if for 0.40, here's the thickness of this. So 4.4, we have 0. 4.6, we have 145 kilonewton meters squared. That's the, what we call it as an ice or ice load. Back to what we have here. So what we have here, yeah, the primary loads, I mean. We have the seismic load. The seismic load, it will be effect on this body of water, and it will be effect on this body of the dam itself. So then there will be a magnitude. How much is that magnitude? It will, we have a vertical. So this pushing, it will seismic pressure. There will be a push, return and back. And this is horizontally. So there will plus minus. Plus minus what? Plus minus the load itself. How much is the P here? It will be, there will be the same magnitude times a factor, which is called seismic horizontal factor. This is in addition to what we have. So we have this one. In worst condition, there will be a push, another push by the same magnitude by the alpha, and or sometimes it will be less than this one. So it will be plus and minus a load. This is what we have horizontal. What we have here is the wave. Sometimes we have the wave due to the wind, there will be a wave. How much is the wave? 1/3. So the depth of the one, the depth here, I will take 1/3 of this depth, and I will use for that 1/3 equation, which is belongs to the wave load. Here's, I think it is a wave. Long self weight, no. Anyway, I think it's somewhere here. It's written in the exam, in the papers. Now, here's what we have for seismic. For seismic, we will have the force itself times the horizontal factor, and we will have the forces times of a vertical factor. What's that PM? PM is a self weight. By the way, I say that, yes, we will have a load. There will be, this is the mass of the concrete dam itself. So this mass may be go to forward or come back. This is what cause a load, an extra load, and it's called a dynamic or hydrodynamic wave. Here's the hydrodynamic P wave. And this is the P wave can be considered like this, 2 times gamma of water times the HS. HS is the height of the wave. For example, here's the wave. The wave, the depth of the wave. So the HS, HS is equal to 1/3 of that, wave will be one over h. Here's the edges, it's a significant height and the mean height of the highest third wave in a sample. Now, we say, okay, we say that we have the head, yes. We will have, So yeah, we have done with this one, and this and this and this. Now what's left for you? Also, we have this, the mass of the concrete itself. So I can say I will have a mass of concrete dam. Here's the mass of the concrete dam. So how many meter cube of concrete that I have here? Here's the problem. How much is the meter cube? How much meter cube of concrete? Or let me say this is if it was a dam concrete, concrete dam. So how much is meter cube that I have for that concrete? Then after that means you have to find the volume, right? Now I have to find the volume of this tank. How to find the volume of this tank? I will find the area of this cross-sectional shape and I will multiply it by one. How to find the area of this shape? It will be easy. You have this slope and you can make it in two or three parts and find the area of them. And then after that, you have to multiply it by the volume. When you have the volume, you will say specific weight of concrete, it's about 2.5 to 3.5 tons per meter cube. So every 1 meter cube of concrete may load, give you a load about 2.5 to 3.5 tons. Now we have, and this will be vertical load, vertical. So vertical loads comes from this one. Yes, so it will come from this one. And yes, how to solve this one? I need the vertical loads. I need the, sometimes here's, this is, there is another loads that we have. Due to the seepage, what that means, we have seepage flow. That means the dam itself, there is a porous, the porous pores, which are very little. Upstream, we have upstream, and there will be downstream. So there will be a flow of the of this water through the body of the dam, and it will be very little. But sometimes we have to what? You have to make a gallery. We have to make, let me say, like we have a channel, small channel, just to collect the water that came in here that will penetrate the skin of the dam somehow and it will come here. So we will make a drain. This is called a relief, drain relief for this one. So anyway, this water will, when it's porous, it will call the drain. They will make, there will be an extra load on this one. So there will be, look at this one, there will be an opposite, yeah, there will be a pressure on this dam. It's called uplift. So we have uplift pressure. Uplift pressure, it means there is a dam and the part of the dam is under the ground, under the water. So there will be an uplift. It will try to lift up the body of the dam to this space. Now, how to find this one? Based on the how much water that I have here, there will be the pressure. So as much as we have higher value of the pressure, as much as the ground or the water in the bottom try to kick out this dam above. Now, how much is that one we have? There's Z1, here's the Z1. The Z1 value is from here to there. So this is considered as the Z1. Here we have Z2, here's the Z2. So gamma Z2 is here. And there will be a distribution and there will be a less value of the, this is in case that we don't have any drain. But if I have a drain, we will put a gallery, then I will relieve the pressure. This is in case that I want to relieve the pressure, then it will become like this. Now, how much is the value? It will depend on Z, yes, Z1 gamma and Z2 gamma. Now, to calculate the loads, it will be what? How to calculate the loads that coming out, lifting the dams up, It will be by multiplying this pressure. This is a pressure. Taking the average, I multiply it by the by this area, the foundation area of this dam. And how to take the average, I will find this stress and take the average of them. I multiply by B, here's the B, base of the foundation multiplied by the one. This is the area and there will be another load. So till now we have vertical loads that's coming from the dam, self weight of the dam itself. We have again, vertical loads that comes out from the uplift pipes, uplift pressure. There will be a horizontal that's coming up. Sometime in some dams, there will be look like this shape. So sometimes in the dams, we will have some kind of shapes like this. So besides of the pressure, the horizontal loads here, we have a mass of water that acting on this part. This mass will cause a vertical pressure, vertical one, and this vertical one acts on here. Then we should be careful. We have to calculate the loads on this part. Okay, here's like this. So this is will be the vertical part. Now, I think I give you a summary of the loads that will be acting on a dam. I don't want to go furthermore until you say that you understood all the loads. Do you understand the loads that we have? Is there anything you want to more clarification?
Doctor, the horizontal one is the water and the vertical one is concrete?
Yeah, not always. So the self weight will almost be down. This is right. So we have two self weights. There's a self weight. The self weight means the weight of the dam itself. So it will be down, right?
Yes.
This is vertical load. And by the way, this is in case of having no earthquake. Okay, when we have an earthquake, we will have this load plus another load that's coming from the earthquake. And this load that's coming from earthquake, it's called also vertical, but times the alpha vertical. Alpha vertical, it's plus minus, which is belongs to the earthquake region. So in case of that, we don't have earthquake, the self weight itself, it will be the vertical one. This is one. If we have earthquake, there will be the self weight and plus the earthquake weight. This is two. Sometimes, as I told you, the shape, look at the shape. Yeah, there is a shape. There is a line here, right? So it means that if I want to go up, I have vertically, I have another part of water that acting on this surface. Do you see that? No. On this surface. And just let me, this surface and this surface. Vertically, yes, there is another load that will act if this is not straight vertically. If this is not straight, look at this, there is a slope. There is a slope, right? So there will be somehow a part, a mass of water that acting on this part vertically, right? Then it will call another pressure, vertical pressure that coming from water that act on this one. So besides of that, we have a horizontal force of water, there will be a vertical load, but this vertical load will act on this face.
Doctor, so that water pressure, that vertical one, did we use the same rule that unit wide multiply by h?
Yeah, how to calculate the for example, I want to calculate the loads that acting on this surface. Let me say this is exaggerated. This is the body of the dam. Okay, this is the body of the dam. I want to calculate how much is the water that acting on here, right? This is water. So the vertical one that coming from water is equal to what? It's equal to mass of the water. Okay, I have this, I can divide this part and this part alone and say I will find the volume of them. Okay, and multiply by gamma of water, multiply by the width, 1 meter width will cause give me volume, and the volume I'll multiply by the gamma unit weight. So I can say I have this is going to Newton meter cube, and this is volume of the water, meter cube of the water that we have. There will be an effect on this one. That's how we can find the loads that acting on the face of this.
Okay, thank you.
I hope it will be clear, right? Now, the one that's important for us, first of all, we will come back. Here's the distribution. So we have the horizontal, this is will be the horizontal force of water. So this is horizontal force. After finding, so we have Z1 here is from Z1. So the center of this force will be 1/3 from the base. So 1/3, it's 0.33 times. This is in case that we don't have earthquake. If I have earthquake, there will be in addition to that force, another force, which is the horizontal water earthquake. And its magnitude, we say that it's equal, it could be equal to alpha horizontal diameter to this one. And how much is the magnitude? This is the magnitude. And on how much depth it will act? It's act on 0.4 Z1. That's why we should consider this one, and we should include in our calculation. So for vertical, for horizontal horses, now we have two ones. We have one normal without earthquake. This is with earthquake, and the centroid of this force will be 1/3 of this one, and the centroid of this one will be 0.4 of this edge. That's what we need. Its magnitude is already here. Now for the vertical part, here is the vertical pipe, and if this phase is not having any slope going down, so it means there is no water vertical load. There will not be water. So here is the water. This one, it will be the area of this part times 1 times gamma water. And this will be due to the vertical part, or let me say the incline of the face, upstream face. If there is no any angle of inclining, so it means it's equal to zero. Besides of that, we should have considered again the earthquake. The earthquake load, it will equal to the same load times an alpha vertical, and the center of this load will be the same center of this one. This is in case of vertical loads. Here's the one we have, the centroid, by the way, for the dams that we have. Here's the dam we have. When I want to calculate the weight of the dam, so it's the volume times the gamma concrete. In case of having an earthquake, you should have to be aware that you should find this one. PU is the uplift pressure. When we say there is an uplift here and there will be an uplift here. So what I have to do, I have to find the average of them times the base times the 1 meter, and I will get the value of the uplift pressure. And sometimes in the tail, so here's hell, here's toy. In the toy, there will be water upstream. Water is called toy water level. There will be Z2, and this Z2 will be here. And the location of this one, look at this one, it will act on this way. It will be 1/3 of Z2, that's what we know. And now it's the time to, why do I have to know all these loads? Because we are going to analyze the safety of this dam. The safety of the dam against what? Against, we have three criteria. We have three factor of safeties. First of factor of safeties, are the dam is going to be rotate or overturning? It means that it will not collapse. It will not collapse. It will gonna be overturning, look like this. Yeah, so the dam will be look like this. How this is will overturn around a point, right? So it will, there will be a rotation around a point. How do this will be? Due to what? If I have the loads, the horizontal loads greater than the vertical loads, right? So it will be overturned. We have a horizontal loads, we have a vertical loads. And the vertical loads, I mean the weight of the dam itself. So if the pushing was great, so it will make that one. If we don't have any collapse in the dam itself, then it will be overturning, which is means failure. Now, we should find the factor of safety against rotation and overturning. How to do that? And this is one. This is one. Again, we have another thing that we have transition and sliding. It means sometimes the dam here was here, and due to the loads, it go slided or transit. It's not rotated, but it's moved from the point to another point. This is called transition, or it was slided. Slided means that maybe it comes here. It comes here. So look at this one. Sliding or translation. Also the vertical and the horizontal loads will act on this one. And here's in this one, we need to know how much is the resistance, because this dam is, let me say, it's adhered to the ground, right? So we should have a friction. The friction that's on the bottom of this dam will take a part to resist this dam and will not let it to go to be slided. Now, the sliding should be considered the type of the rock or the bed of the dam itself in against sliding. Overstressing and material failure. Sometimes there will be a failure in a part of the dam. For example, in this part, there will be the collapse of this one, this part. So there will be, this is a dam. There will be somehow here, this part will be cut or collapsed due to overstress. So there will be a pressure here, there will be a pressure here. So due to small pressure and here's high pressure, this will be cut. The cutting, and that's what we call it as a material failure or overstress of the material. And that's what we have to find the factor of safety against these kind of. Criteria 1 and criteria 2, the tube overturning and sliding, overall, this is it's a kind of structural stability. It's related to the stability of the structure itself. Both must be specified and respect to the profile horizontal planes. We should know how much is that one. The overstress, the three one, must be satisfied from the damp concrete. For the damp concrete especially, we have to this should be satisfied. And for the rock foundation, so the rock foundation, it will be the failure in the rock or in the concrete itself. Now, so we will find the factor of safety, first of all, against the overturn. To do that, we have to find the summation of the moments that will stabilize in this dam. What is the forces that make this dam to be stabilized? Could you tell me what forces that make this this dam to be stabilized? I think you all read just the weight of the dam itself, right? So this is what we have, what's the stabilizing the, what is the forces that making the dam to be overturned? It is the horizontal forces, right? Now, here's the uplift. Sometimes we have the uplift. So the over the vertical loads, the uplift loads here, this uplift will resist that that force as vertical. And here's the horizontal one. And let's agree with these directions. Vertical loads, if they were down, it will agree to be positive. And if this is the direction of the positive way, because it's very important. Now, this is the stabilizing moments and overturning moments. Moments, it means what? Moments is not forces, by the way, moments. So moment, it means a force times distance, right? So we are going to find against this this point. We want to know the dam will come, will go further. It will be look like this. This is overturning, so it will be rotate against this point. And this is what we have. So this is the toy. So I want to find the horizontal force on this face and its distance. Already we know that this distance is 1/3 of this edge. So I have to find the value times this one. And then I want to find the moment. Here's the moment. Now, should I consider this is positive? No, because this is negative. The moment, whatever we have, it's positive, this is negative. Anyway, so you have to say, okay, I will consider this force times this distance plus. Do we have any other forces? Yes, or negative. We have the weight of the dam itself, the vertical weight, times this distance. So I should find the centroid of the loads and then multiply them by a distance, and the uplift pressure multiplied by distance, and overall I will have this ratio. This is could we say it's a factor of safety against the sliding. I'm not just I will leave this part. I will go to the exam directly, an example directly, to not let me say misleading. Look at this one, this example. It say that we have a dam, concrete dam. We have maximum water level is 305. If we have a bed level, 225. So here's the maximum level, which is equal to 3.309, the 305. Yeah, this is wrong, it's five. Yeah, this is 305, here's maximum level of water. The bed water level is 225. So can you tell me how much is the depth of water that we have, the maximum here? The Z or the edge?
305 minus 225.
It's equal to 309 minus 225, right? It's equal to 80.
So is the water level at 309?
I mean the water level. How much is the level of water in the? How much is the depth of water in this dam? So the water level, the maximum water level was 305, and the bed level is 225 bed level. So how much is the depth of water in this tank? Maximum H is 309 minus 225, right? Sorry, 4.
Sir, 305.
Sorry.
305.
84 meter. Why? It's not 85, 84. It's 84. 309 minus 220, 225. Is it how much? 84 meter, right?
Yes.
Now I have 84 meters depth of water. Now, if I want to measure the horizontal force and look at the dam itself, it's a vertical, it's a straight line, right? There is no any angle. This is 9, so there is no any other parts. So the gamma H, Yeah, so this is will be the gamma H. Can you tell me how much is the load that acting on this face? The P horizontal. The P horizontal is equal, here's the pressure in this one, it's equal to gamma H, which sigma gamma water, 9.81 times H is equal to 84 meter. So it's 9.81 gamma H times 84. This is the pressure here. So I want to know how much is the load. So the load is equal to this one, 1/2 times this pressure, 84 times 9.81. Gamma H times the H, because I want to know how much is the area. Yeah. How much is the area of this force distribution? This is gamma H, this is H. 1/2 gamma H times the H. Times the one, by the way, if I want to find the volume, so it will be 1/2 gamma H square. Okay, so the force is equal to this volume times one, times the gamma of water, that will be, so it's equal to 1/2 gamma 9.81 kilonewton meter cube times, how much is the H? We have 84 meter square, it will be meter square. Times 1 meter, so I will get meter cube. So this is the kilonewtons that will act vertically, horizontally, sorry. In which depth, where is the centroid of this force? It's 1/3 of the 84. If I want to measure the distance from the resultant force to the point that I want to take the moment, so 84, divided by 3 will give you this force. This is in case that we have only the horizontal force without having any, earthquake. Now, look at this one, the crest level. Here's the crest level. I don't include the crest level in calculating the hertz. Here's the crest level. The crest, this is what we call, this is the crest. The crest of this dam is 309. Now, if I want to calculate the loads that's going that's going to act on this dam, vertically, yeah, this is the dam itself, the body of the dam. So this is all in concrete, right? So how much is the loads that could be acting or it's stabilizing the the body of the dam. This is the all which we have. Okay. I will divide this part, this dam, into two phases, into two region, two parts. This is the one, and this is the two. So I can, the weight that coming from this part, I will name it as a weight two or weight one, and I will say the weight that's coming from this part is one weight. Now, I should know how much is the weight that coming from this part of concrete, right? So the volume is equal to area times the one, right? I will take the one that's unit. Now, one is okay. The area is should equal to W, the width of the crest, times the edge. Edge is here. We have this edge is equal to how much? 309 minus 225. So 309 minus 225 will equal to how much?
I think it's
84.
Okay.
300. 84. So how should come? 305.
Yes, on
horizontal.
Yeah. This one you use 309, it should have been 305.
This is 80. This is 80. This is 84. I'm from here. So this is 84. I'm sorry. Now, I have the width. Yeah, here's the width of the crest, or the height of the crest is 84. And look at this one. It said for any dam, if you have its height, then the crest, the width of the crest will equal to square root of the height. This is empirical equation until now we use it. Now, we have 84. So how much it should be here? And by the way, and again, it's very important to know that the width of the crest will equal to square root of the height. Now we have the height, it's 84. Taking the square root of 84 will equal to 9 point how much? 84. Hmm. 9.16 meter. It means you have to be satisfied with 9.1, but we are, as an engineer, we will take more because I want to build, let me say, there will be a road here and there. So I want to have at least two lane roads plus side slope, plus those shoulders. So I will increase it and I will make it as a 12 meter. So I can, yes, you will be sometimes familiar with having your experience for this dimension. So I will use W is equal to 12 meter. Now you know how this 12 comes from? Hello?
Can you repeat?
Amir?
Yes, doctor.
Do you know why, how we did bring that 12, the width of the crest?
Yeah.
How?
Because of the shoreline and the, because it might be, there's a rod on the dam, so we increased the size of the of the edge.
From 9.1 meter?
Yeah, from 9 to 12.
So, and by the way, we should have an even numbers. It will be better than odd numbers. Okay. This is one.
So now, can we say it's 10?
Yes, you can. But the 10 meters, it means We should leave 1.5 meter for the side street shoulders. If a river, this is 1.5 and 1.5, that was 3. So we leave, if it's only 7 meters. And by the way, there's no dams with a crest less than 10 meters. This is be aware. So 10 meters, it's okay. Okay, you can use 10 meters. And I'm using 12, you can use 14, but normally it will be 12.
Doctor?
Yes.
Do we have a maximum number? Like we cannot go like or exceed that number?
No, just we have to take this part and we say the width of the crest of the wheel will be most likely, this is empirical equation by the way, and it will be square root of the h, where h in meter, by the way. And this is will be in meter. And it tried to have plus 2 meter, 3 meters, and that will be good. Okay.
Another question. In order to get the depth, we deducted 305 from 225, right?
No, 300, the crest height. This is the maximum, the crest height. When we are talking about the body of the dam, so you should consider the dam itself, not the water. Even the level of water is zero, you should not take the zero, you should take the depth of the dam. This is the height. The height of the dam, so H, how much is the H? H is the height of the dam, not the water. Because we are talking about the body of the dam, which is the crest of the dam. That's what I'm talking about. I'm finding it's about square root of the H, and H here is the maximum. It's from the bed level to the top crest level. Okay. Okay. Now it's time to calculate this weight. And it's centered. How to find this? So we agree that the W is equal to 12 meter. Now to find the W, the weight, I will say, it's equal to 12 times 84. Right, times one, this is become volume of 1 meter cubed, yes, times the gamma of concrete. And you say that 2.5 tons to 3.5 tons per 1 meter cube will give you and this will be. Now, how much is the location of that W from the toy? Can you say, then this is 12, okay? If that's 12, and there is a level of water, or let me say there is the crest, or let me, this is called the downstream slope. And it's given to us. The downstream slope is 2 to 3. And it will start at a level of 300. So at a level of 300, so 225 years to level 300 is there. So from this one, it will become decreasing 2 to 3. Two horizontal, this is horizontal, and this is vertical. So at every 3 meters depth, there will be a 2 meters widening. And then I can say, so this is how much it could be. We know that this depth is how much? It's 300 minus 225, right? 75 meters, we will have a lane down. For that 75, so how much it should be getting back? Or let me say, so 2/3, it look like how much over, look at me. So 2/3, it look like how much X over 75. It look like it's 2X equal to 2/3 times 75, which is equal to 50 meter. Now, what's that tell us? That's tell us there is 50 meters from here. Okay, so there is a 50 meter. Now we have 12 meters from here to the top crest, and we have 15. So the overall the base of the dam is equal to how much? 62 meters. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Now I want to let me erase this one. Now, again, we say that to calculate the W1, you have to be patient with the calculation because it's a dam. W1 is equal to 12 meters times 80, this is 84, times 1 times gamma concrete, 2.5 ton per meter cube. This is for W1, and its location will be how much? So look at this one, how much is the location? From this drawing?
I think 39.
The distance. Now we have from here to there is 50, right? And from here to this center, because it's center of the 12, we have 6. So the total is 56, right? So I have, when I want to find the moment of this part, I will multiply this 50, this the weight by 56 to get the moment around this point. Okay. I think it's clear, right?
50. Yes,
there is 56. To go to this part, this part of the body of the concrete, let me say it, I will name it as a YW2. So the this is a triangular shape. So the volume of this one for 1 meter is equal to 1 over 2 times the base, 50 times the depth. How many is that? Is 75. Times the 1, this is the volume of this part. Times also gamma concrete will give you the load start coming from this part. Again, so I have the weight that's coming from this part, which is called W2. Now, I want to find the moment of this force from the toy. How much is that? It's from this, how much is the distance that the resultant force will come to this point? It's, let us ask, Arina?
It's 2/3 of the base of that triangle.
Very good. And the 2/3 of that triangle base is equal to 2/3 times
50.
Good, very good. And because this is 1/3 and this is the left will be 2/3. Now we know that we have W1, we have W2, we have F force from this part. The only one thing is left for us to consider is the uplift pressure. There will be a lift of the uplift pressure here and will be uplift pressure. This is called heel. It's like a woman's shoe. We have a heel, we have a toy. And so this heel, and this is the toy, and there will be a pressure here. Let us check. We know that this uplift pressure, it depends on the how much is the depth of water here. So how much is the depth of water here? It's 80, right? So it will be gamma H. Gamma H, it means gamma water times the 80. And how much is the uplift pressure here? It will depend on the how much water is left here. And I think we don't have it. So we should consider it at a zero, or it will tell us. They say that at the heel, there will be 100% uplift pressure. At the toy, there will be zero pressure. At the drainage gallery, there will be 50 pressure. So where is the drainage gallery? There will be a drainage gallery 8 meters downstream of the upstream. of the upstream face. There is an upstream. This is the upstream face. So you have to go 8 meters from upstream to the downstream. By 8 meters, there will be a gallery. In this gallery, there will be a pressure of uplift pressure by 50%. 50% of what? Of this one. So if this is was a gamma H 80 times gamma water, there will be, this is 0.5 times 80. And we have at the toy, we have zero. Zero. Look at this shape. So now we have three, I can say this is the pressure. The pressure I should calculate, I should find this pressure. To find this force that's coming from this pressure, I should find the area of the pressure times the width of the dam. So look at this one. The width of the dam, we have 56, right? Times one, so the area of the base of the dam is equal to 56 times 1 meter square. Now, okay, I have to find the pressures of this one. So if this is was gamma H all and the pressure, so I will divide all the pressure in three parts. Well, this is one part. This is could be first part. This is second part, and this is third part. I will name this one as a U1, U2, U3. U1, it means under uplift pressure one. Uplift pressure one, it's based the area, find this area. It's 8 meter. This is 8 meter times the 1 meter. This is the area times. So 8 times 1, here's the 1, times the pressure. This is meter square. The pressure on this part is equal to half 0.5, because all are 80. So how should all 80, and this is 50% of that 80, so it means 40. So this is 40. 40 what? 40 meter gamma water. So this is, I will find 40 meters gamma water times H, this will be the resultant, times the area, which is again, so 40 gamma water times 8 meters, this is the area of this pressure, times the 1 times 8, also the area, it will give you how much is kilonewtons that we have acting on this part. There will be another part here, and there will be another part here. So we will have U1, U2, U3. This is the way that we are going to consider. And for each one, for example, if I want to consider to find the, this is was the uplift pressure. I want to consider this is U1. When I conclude this one, so it will act on this part. It means 4 meters from here to there, and again, 50 meters. So 54 meters is left for this force. The U1 will add to the toy. And we have for U2, and we have for U3. And after all, you have to find the factor of safety by taking the moments around the toy, and you will have these forces. And one force, two force, three forces, one, two, three, four, five, six forces we have. So finding if six forces times each of them at the distance from the toy, you will find the factor of the safety. Here's all the one that I talked about. Here's how to find the pressure. So the horizontal pressure is the 1/2 times this is the 80. This is 8.5, this is the 80, and this is the 84. So there will be horizontally 3,200 tons, and it will be located at 1/3 of the 80, so 26.67. And for the loads, the self weight, I will, this is D1. So 12 times 84 times 2040, this is the gamma kilonewton per meter cube. This is the gamma concrete. And I will change it to tons, so divided by 1,000. So there will be 2,419.2 tons. This is just for this part. And it will act on 656. Now, the W2 is equal to 1 over 2. This is 1 over this part. 1 over 2 times the base, which is 15, times the depth, which is 75. Times the gamma of concrete divided by 1,000, it will give you vertically 4,500 tons. So vertically we have 2,000, there is 4,000. So as a total, we have 6,900 tons. Also, you can see how much it will act. It will act by 2/3 of the 50, like Arina said. So it's 33.33 meter. Now, the total vertical loads that's coming from the self weight is equal to W1 and W2. That's the total. Now, the uplift pressure here is the uplift pressure. There will be zero at this one because they don't have any water downstream. We have gamma H, here's gamma H. And this point is due to the drain. We have 8 meters upstream phase downstream. So there will be 50%. So 50% of what? 50% of the gamma H. So there is one. And that's what we have it to calculate this one. Okay. Now, I want to see, how much is the U1 and U2, U3. So the U1, we say that we have, this is how much, it's 100% of gamma H. H is the depth of water, which is 80 meters. So 80 meters times the gamma of water, which is, let me say, 1,001 tons per meter cube. So 80, yes, the U1 is this first one. U1, I mean, the U1 here is the U1. This is half, then it will be half, because this point is half. So half of what? The half of one gamma H. Gamma is 80. Gamma is in ton. And then this is the depth times the H, 8 meter. This is will give you a resultant force that acting on this part. And where is the location of this part? It's 60, 50 plus, it's not a 60, it's also, it's 62 all minus 4. 62 minus 4, it means 58. Okay, this is the locations. And for U2, here is the third two part, there is another triangle. This triangle, we have 1 over 2 of this depth, 0.5 times 80, times 8, the base, and there will be the 160 tons. This is from that part. And there will be U3, and the U3 is equal to half of the base, which is 58. We have 50, all 62 minus 4, 54, sorry, because it's 8. Now, what's left for you? 62 minus 8, 54. So 1 over 2 times the base, 54 times the depth. Here's the depth of the uplift pressure, is 0.5 times H times gamma. Now we have uplift pressure from part 3. Here's part 3. And then the total uplift that's coming up, it will be the resultant force from 1, 2, 3. There is the 1, 2, 3 forces. So in general, we have how much? So I can summarize all the things that we have by loads and uploads, PM, P uplift, and horizontal. The total vertical loads due to that, it was 6,000, I think, 6,900 tons. The vertical, the horizontal ones, it was 3,200 tons. So 3,200 tons horizontal, vertical, 6,900 uplift, it was 1,560 tons. Now, what is the factor of safety? Factor of safety is means that every load multiplied by it's the distance from the toy, not the hill. So you will find the vertical one, and I will consider this is positive, or you can say I will go with this one. So this times this one, we have all, this is could be added to this one. So 1,000 times the 26, here's 26. And the U3 times 59 and U386 and U2. You can see the factor of safety is 1.87, which is greater than 1.5. It means the stabilizing forces moments is greater than the rotational forces. By how much? By more than 1.5. And we will accept this factor of safety when it's more than 1.5 in normal cases. Then I can say this dam is safe. This is what we have against the rotation. We have the stabilizing forces. The stabilizing, it means it will not not to let the dam go and slide or let me transport. So it means the how much is the forces that will help, will try to push the dam, divided the forces that will not help or make them in this location vertically. So the total horizontal, which we have 3,200, the vertical ones, we have the loads that from the total loads, the weights, the 6,900 that's coming from the concrete minus the uplift one, which is 1,500, and the net is equal to 5,359. So the factor of safety, it means 0.59. It means the horizontal forces are very little, less than the verticals, because this ratio is a ratio between the horizontal to the vertical. Less than the vertical ones by 0.59, it means that it will stay in its location and not sliding, even not transporting. That's the factor of safety against sliding. And the exceeded or the limit that we have, it should not be more than 0.75. And now we have 0.59. So we can say it's again, this dam is safe for against sliding or sliding factors. We have another factor, we will leave it for the next lecture. Okay, do you have any question?
Sir, when will you send us the grades, the exam grade?
For water sources, I'm yes. Maybe tonight or tomorrow, because I'm done with them. That's because we did it late, right?
Yeah.
I will send it to you by today or tonight. Okay.
Well, thank you, sir. Hopefully.
Any other question? Okay, so. See you next lecture, inshallah.
See you, sir. Goodbye.
Bye-bye.
Bye, sir.
Thank you, doctor.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Bye-bye. Thank you. Thank you all.